So I'll walk you through our water treatment plant that we have here for arsenic removal in Allensworth. We're treating the influent groundwater, which is naturally very high in arsenic. The first step in our treatment train is right here. We have our electrochemical reactors. And this being a steel plate, we're just generating a kind of rust that the arsenic can bind to within this reactor. So the water we collect in this tank is all of the rusty water that we just created in the above electrochemical reactors. The rusty water then gets pumped out with a submersible pump and dosed with alum, a coagulant to bring particles together and make them bigger. And then that water enters our flocculation chamber, where we allow particles to mix together, bump into each other, and get big enough to just settle out by gravity in the next steps. This is our settling tank. You'll notice it's a lot bigger. It gives particles more time to fall out of solution. And so the kind of the where all of the arsenic ends up is in the sludge, and you'll see that being collected here at the bottom. Then after our settling tank, we have just the water on top. So the clear water on top of the settling tank overflows into just a holding tank so that we're able to again pump all of that water that's mostly clean through the rapid sand filter, removing a lot of the particles that have, you know, escaped the treatment step up until here, and they get stuck onto the sand and trapped into the filter. So after the rapid sand filter, we have the micron filters, and they're removing the tiniest of particles that have made it through our treatment step. We take samples every hour to check on a few key water quality parameters like pH, dissolved oxygen, and we also take rapid tests for arsenic concentrations. So the influent groundwater has about 200 parts per billion arsenic, and by the time it reaches the end of our treatment train and we've treated this water, it's coming out consistently below 10 parts per billion. So it's a really, really fun time to be a part of the Gadgil lab, trying to come up with solutions for these water problems. And so being a part of this team that gets to join those efforts is really rewarding.